Hello everyone, welcome to Study ATEC, and in this video we are going to explain the half-wave controlled rectifier with freewheeling diode. Well, in the previous video we have raised a problem. That problem was with RL load without this diode, freewheeling diode with RL load, what we got, current became continuous, which was highly desirable. That good thing we got the continuous current waveform, that absolutely fine, but at the same time we got the VO average was decreasing because of the negative swings were appearing in the load side, so that was making the average voltage decreased. Now how to solve that problem? What we have done, we have connected a diode here. Simply we need to connect a diode. What is the function of diode, we will explain later. So let us see. From again we are triggering the device the same way we are triggering the device at some alpha point. Okay, so 0 to alpha, the state of the switch is 0 to alpha. What is the state? 0 to alpha, the state is alternating voltage source, and we are not triggering this device. Okay, and this is also say not conducting. So the resistance and the inductance, all right, so no voltage we will get, and the current we don't also get the current. So here the output voltage VO and here the input voltage VI, and the output voltage here, if we draw from 0 to alpha, the no switches are on, right, because this is not triggered first of all, secondly, and this is not working, let us assume. Okay, so we will get zero voltage. Okay, fine. So what about the current? Definitely the current will be zero, because how the current will flow, where the current will flow, let us say the current flowing is equal to zero. Later on we will modify this. Anyway, at this point assume that the current is equal to zero. At the moment alpha, what we are doing, we are suddenly triggering this device, okay, through this gate terminal. So when we trigger the device thyristor, the situation will be something like this. All right, this is a closed path, this will become closed path, and this positive voltage is appearing across this diode and the negative voltage is appearing across this terminal of the diode. So that makes this diode reverse biased. So what will happen? The current will increase. This is an inductive load simply. So the current will flow somewhere here, it will be max, then it will decrease, and you will get the input voltage. But we see here at the point pi, current is not equal to zero. The current is not equal to zero, so we can say thyristor will not be off. This is like simple RL circuit, the thyristor will not be off. Now the diode will come to the picture. How? Because what will happen here, look, the moment the pi point is reached, at the point pi the voltage polarity is zero, and right after this point pi plus we will get this point is negative and this point is positive. All right, at the same time, look what is happening is that current that was flowing through the inductor, it was going in this way. Now the moment this voltage becomes zero, and right after this peak the current is falling, so the nature of the inductor, it will taint the current to flow. Okay, it will allow the current to flow, so we are giving a path, so current will now flow in this direction, because the negative voltage, first of all, negative voltage is appearing and it is getting a short path. So the inductor will discharge through this path. Actually, inductor has two paths, this path and this path. If we say the thyristor is not off, but it has to overcome this voltage. All right. So it will get a better path. Through this closed path, the entire current will flow. So as if the current is flowing, or current is confined in the output loop. So we will get the current will flow. But the voltage across this device, or the voltage across the load, is zero. You may imagine how this voltage is zero, because this is RIT, LDIDT, but apply the KVL here. VO or the VO is not the voltage across the resistor or the inductor, the voltage, and this is a short circuit, this point and this point is the same, so we will get the zero voltage. So this is something like that, resistance, inductance, but we are closing this and we are measuring the voltage between these two points. What will it be? The inductor is discharging. So zero voltage, isn't it? Okay. So the zero voltage we will get. But zero voltage we will get, but the current will flow. And we are assuming the current is flowing something like that and current is becoming zero here, right? So if the current becomes zero here, what we will get? I will draw for the thyristor voltage later on, but we will get the zero voltage here. So this is the profile. This is the output current. Now here, from this point to this point, here this current is taken care of by the main thyristor, and here the conduction of the current is through FD, and FD is nothing but, this is called FD, the freewheeling diode. So this is the thing. Well, in this two axis, we will draw the input voltage, and here you will draw the IFD, and here IT. So IT and the source current profile will be same. And in the negative half cycle, same thing will happen. Zero. And from here we will get some current, will be something like that, and it is triggered again at through pi plus alpha. So this is the scenario. Now the voltage across the thyristor, where the thyristor is conducting from alpha to pi, the voltage across it is equal to zero. And when this device, this thyristor is closed, it is freewheeling. Freewheeling action is, you can imagine, if you are cycling and suddenly you have stopped pedaling, what will happen? It will run by its own. We will get a freewheeling action. The same thing is here. So what will be the voltage across this device? Now the polarity has become negative and positive, and this voltage will appear across the device, right? So you will get a negative voltage. So from this point, from this pi point, okay, we are getting a negative voltage across the device. So we will get this one. Well, now this current can be, this current can be more flat depending upon the L value, and we can get a continuous conduction. Sorry, I think I have done a little bit of mistake. This voltage waveform will be here, and this current waveform will be here actually. Okay, so we will get a current waveform something like that. So now here, as initially we assumed that the current is zero here, but somehow if we take the steady state, some current will exist here, this current. So little bit of mistake I had done here, so I am drawing it clearly. This is a voltage, these are the points, and the alpha, 2 pi plus alpha, and the current waveforms will be maximum, then the current is not becoming zero and something like that. And here, from here to here, the thyristor conducts, and here the FD conducts. Okay, so this is the, previously it was discontinuous conduction, now it is continuous conduction. So that is a freewheeling diode's action, or the effect of freewheeling diode. Freewheeling diode's action are two. One is to remove negative swing. Another is to commute thyristor T means making it off, because the moment this diode starts conducting, the current through the thyristor becomes zero, and immediately this become off. So the function of the freewheeling diode is two. One is to remove the negative swing, making the zero voltage, and to immediately commute the thyristor. So that is the function of the thyristor here, sorry, the freewheeling diode. So this is the action of the freewheeling diode. Okay, hope you like the video. Keep watching, keep building up the concepts, and please subscribe to our channel. Thank you. See you in the next video.